नमस्कार एवरीबडी, दिस इज द प्योर मैग्नेट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट अ सीरियस सब्जेक्ट. इट इज थिंक फॉर योर सेल्फ. यस फ्रेंड्स, आई हमली रिक्वेस्ट यू, प्लीड यू, थिंक फॉर योर सेल्फ. आई एम गोइंग टू पॉइंट आउट 10 features regarding which you and I need to think. Many a time as we grow up, we are just molded by different things, molded by the exterior, maybe by our parents, by our relatives, by our culture, religion, traditions, by our environment, and we become a puppet. We don't think for ourselves. We are just guided our entire life by somebody else. So, first point. Culture, religion and traditions. See, as when a child is born, what does he think of? He thinks of survival. He wants something to eat or to drink. He doesn't know what is happening. So parents take care of the child. He is brought up in a certain culture. If you are born in India, you are brought up in an Indian culture, either in a Hindu family or a Buddhist family or a Muslim family or a Christian family, okay? And that is the way you are bred, brought up, you go to a certain school, institution, you follow certain religion. If your parents were Hindus, you become a Hindu. If parents followed Islam, you become a Muslim. If your parents were belonging to any Christian organization, you become a Christian. That is the way it is. But what about thinking for yourself? For example, let me just reason with you. For example, a Hindu worships goddess Saraswati. But still in India, there is so much illiteracy, right? People worship goddess Ma Lakshmi, but still there is poverty in India and around the world, isn't it? People worship Lord Ganesha, the remover of obstacles, but still there are so many obstacles. So my point is, does the worship of gods and goddesses, does it help in any way to bring in knowledge or wisdom or to bring in material prosperity or to remove obstacles? Not really. We have been just blindly following the traditions, the culture, the religion. The point to think about, are you able to think for yourself, see beyond what you are taught? Second is relationships, romance and sex. As a person becomes a teenager, he comes under peer pressure. He sees, that guy has a boyfriend or a girlfriend, or people are getting involved in romance and you do not really feel like, okay? But somehow under pressure, you get attracted to somebody. And about sex, should you give in virginity or not? If you do not want to give up virginity, why should you? Where is it written that if you are a virgin all your life, you're incomplete? You're only complete if you are involved with the member of the opposite sex, or, you know? We are just wired into some kind of mold. So think differently. You are a different individual, you're unique. Like our thumbprint. We all have unique thumbprints, isn't it? Similarly, you are a different person. You have got thinking ability. You got to think for yourself. Do not follow the crowd. Be an unconventional thinker. Think for yourself. Do what is really beneficial for you. Third is with regard to marriage and parenthood. In Indian culture especially, people are taught by certain age you must get married, have kids. Who says that? To be very honest, marriage and parenthood is not for everybody. Just because your parents got married, your friend got married, your relatives got married, that doesn't mean you must get married, have kids. And once you get married, you are unable to handle your spouse, you are unable to handle your kid, you started blaming your in-laws, your husband, your wife, whole world. But you had a choice. Think about it. What about career? Talking about career, people want to build a good career. What about becoming a good human being? Be at peace with yourself. We have certain goals. And who sets your career? Your family, your friends, or you decide your career? Does it really matter if you become so rich and popular and famous? Or does it really matter if you're really satisfied? You can do what you want with your life. Deep inside, you want to feel free, isn't it? Right? So career is a point that we all got to think about. Am I following my heart? Or am I dominated by people around me? Next is God and prayers. For me, God is an invention of man. There are two kinds of gods. One God without any form, without any attribute. I believe that. But if you look around the world, people follow gods and goddesses and so many things with forms and attributes. For me, God is an invention of man. What about prayers? Many people pray to God. Does it help? It really doesn't help. It is just an imagination. We want to feel good. Oh, if I pray to God, I'll be blessed. And what about unanswered prayers? Your prayers are not answered. And then you have to imagine, oh, God has something better for me. This is nonsense. Your prayers are not answered. And you got to imagine, oh, God has something better for me. What about the concept of heaven and hell? There are many people who claim to be lovers of non-violence. They eat meat and they tell me that I'm going to go to heaven. Wow. Whew. I can't imagine going to heaven. I do not know where heaven is, where hell is. So you got to think for yourself. Is there a God who created everybody? Is it so? Does God really hear our prayers? Or we are just doing because we are taught that God hears our prayers. Somebody has written in the book, oh, God is a living God. He can bless you. He can punish you. He can answer your prayers. Think about it. Think for yourself. For me, I do not pray to God. I do not need to pray to God. Sixth is education. I see many people in India, STEM graduates, they cannot write a proper application in any language. Forget English. There are many STEM graduates in India. They are unable to express themselves properly, communicate properly, yet they are graduates on STEM paper. This is the condition. When we go to an institution, what is our purpose? Do we really seek knowledge for the sake of knowledge? Or we try to get good marks, to get a better job prospects? Or it's all about cash flow? Unfortunately, education is connected to cash flow for many people. Not for me. For me, education is so important. One of the most important features of my life is education. Education for the sake of education, not only for secular purpose. Yes, education should help us to stand on our feet, but besides the monetary advantages, keeping the money part aside, if we are not truly educated, how can we help ourselves? How can we help other people? We are going to have a very poor quality life. Seventh is, this is interesting, parents. Should you obey your parents or should you love and respect your parents? I was brought up being taught you must obey your parents. My father can be a Hitler, can be a big authoritarian, but I must not disobey him. It can lead to real disaster. As you grow up, you realize that something is really nice and beneficial and your parents tell you to do something else. Follow your heart. You love your parents, you respect your parents, you take care of them. That doesn't mean that you have to blindly follow their instructions. Because many a time, that has led people to disaster. Disaster. Just because of obeying parents blindly. Oh, mere pita ne bola hai, maa ne bola hai, toh mujhe karna hi hai. Some people say, my father is God, my mother is God. What is this? Think for yourself. Next is money. We all need money, don't we? But still, most of the people are in poverty. There are people in the world, in India itself, where people do not have a secure job. People do not have a proper roof to stay, do not have nutritious food, and do not have proper clothing. Yes, people are missing out on the basics. So when we have enough money, do we even think about helping the needy people? Or are we satisfied building our big empire? Point to think about. I'm not against money. I hate poverty. But if the money that we have, if we are only using it for our own selfish gains, what is the purpose? What is the purpose of living? Ninth feature is, I'll put it together, law of attraction, law of karma, horoscopes, superstition, occult practices. For me, these are garbage. It doesn't make any sense. Why do you need law of attraction? Why do you need law of karma, a superstition, horoscope, occult practices? I will give you the answer. For fear and greed. To overcome fear and to satisfy our greed. If you do not have any fear, if you are not greedy, you neither need law of attraction, you neither need a law of karma, you neither need superstition, you neither need horoscope, and you neither need occult practices. Nothing. So if you live a healthy life, a scrupulous life, these things are just pieces of garbage. And yet there are millions and millions of people taking the help of such things. Tenth and final one, talking about life, there are two ways to weigh life. 99.99% go for longevity, and few people like me go for wisdom. You have two choices, and you have to make just one choice, either to live a life of longevity or to live a life of wisdom. So when wisdom becomes a high priority, longevity goes at the background. At the foreground, up front is wisdom. So I believe to live wisely, I need to think for myself, not to be guided by what most of the people are doing. Maybe majority of the people might be living a wrong life, but that doesn't mean I must follow the majority. Always going with the flow doesn't help. I have just one life and I need to evaluate, how am I living? So I feel that two important features. One is humility and willingness to learn. Yes, if you want to think for yourself, be humble, have a desire to learn, observe people, and then make your decisions. And you will see that you will find true happiness and satisfaction in your life. Thank you for watching this video.